deceived. Because he had an ulterior motive. He had a reason behind what he was doing. Everywhere you go, everything you do, you better obey that spirit that walks with you. Because if you're walking with a no good spirit, you're going to wind up in a no good place. Some church folks are so sneaky and slick, they're slicker than a watermelon seed. Slicker than a wet seed. Always scheming and plotting. Come on, somebody. Trying to beat somebody out of something. And yet they never took a moment to look in the mirror. And the minute somebody played him, they're going to call somebody by their name. Crafty. Stay away from them Jonadab. We got them in the church. We got them in the neighborhood. We got them in our home. And we got them on our job. Next time somebody amped up, say, get away from me, Jonah. They ain't gonna know what you're talking about, but you gonna know what you're talking about. That's how you catch them off in guard. They ask you a stupid question, you holler out, don't this bus stop at Ames Street and Main Street? They say, what are you talking about? I don't know what you're talking about, neither. Sometimes you gotta go there, amen. You gotta pull a David on them sometimes. They come after you, you gotta start slobbing at them out and acting crazy. They see you acting crazy, they see you on. I know what I'm talking about. I get my stuff right out of the scripture. And you'll see what I'm preaching the deepest about is right in there. This is a hard one. Tamar, who was a virgin with a coat of many colors. I mean, she was a beautiful child to look upon. Come on, somebody. No man has never touched her. Yet her lustful brother desired her. He couldn't hold himself. He couldn't keep himself. Even if he was his own father, David. By custom, he could have married his own sister. But no, he let his lust get the best of him. When your lust get the best of you, you desire things you can't control. Or you think you're slick and hide it from everybody, but everybody sees it, but you. Because you've been wearing that mask for so long. You can't even peel it off because it's a part of your nature. Come on, somebody. Yeah. I'm getting quiet on me now. Yeah. I must have stepped on somebody. Come on, somebody. She came in, she kneeled the bread, she got the food together, she brought it in, but Amnon told all the men servants, everybody, get out! And locked the door behind her. Tamar came in there and the Bible said he raped his own sister. He forced her. It is her. No means
no.
Not maybe, or you just playing a game. No means
no.
You always say it like you mean it. No means what?
No. No.
Say it like you mean it. Don't be scared of me because I can't put you nowhere. You gotta let your yay be yay and your no be no. Because if you pose in between, the enemy needs an opportunity, just like he got an opportunity with Amnon to abuse your sister.
Yes, yes.
The Bible said he forced raped her. Then the Bible said the love that he had for her, in that moment that he finished his wicked deed, the hate he had for her was greater than the love that he had. All in one moment. Don't tell me people won't switch up on you. People will switch up on you in a moment. They'll pull a bait and switch on you and make your head spin. The Bible said when he sent her out, she tried to compromise with him and said, you shouldn't have did this. And send me away in this great anger is worse than what you did. You see, it's that bitterness. It's bitterness that lasts a long time. It's the bitterness. equilibrium that will affect your chemical imbalance in your soul. There are many things in your spirit and in your body you can't get rid of until you deal with that spirit of forgiveness. Sometimes folks hold on to things so long that when a person that they don't like is around them, they start shaking. Come on, somebody. They ain't shaking because they got some bad case of some disease. They're shaking because they're so mad. They're so upset. They shake because they're supposed to forgive somebody. Come on, somebody. But they still shaking. Don't get mad at me. I don't know. He put this woman out. The Bible says she ripped her coat of many colors, her virgin coat, and she poured ashes on her head. And she went down to her brother Absalom's house, and she cried. He said without a hesitation, your brother Amnon did this, didn't he? Isn't it amazing everybody knew what was going down but him? The Bible said, for 2 full years, his half-brother, Absalom, didn't say good, he didn't say bad, he didn't treat him good, he didn't treat him bad, he just made him say. He put on a mask, waiting for the right time. Y'all with me on this? Sometimes the enemy is mad with you, and he's waiting for the right time. He knows you're going to slip up if your mind is somewhere else. Then he's going to try to mess you up. Because he only kills, steal, and destroy. The Bible says that this girl cried. I mean, she cried. David didn't know about it. Nobody else knew about it except for Tamar and Absalom and Amnon. It's amazing when people put on masks of secrecy. Hallelujah! Trying to hide some all their life, and it's eating at them like cats. Take a look in the mirror. Take a strong, hard look in the mirror and ask God to deliver you from whatever ails you. Ask God to help God. He may have called on you in time of trouble. And I'll ask the Bible said 2 full years went by. This man, Absalom, David's son, who tried to kill his own father one time, was waiting in the cut. Come on, somebody. Remember the viciousness of Amnon's rape on his whole sister. And he sought vengeance to get him. And he said, Dad, we're going to be shearing some sheep. Come on up to the sheep shearing. David said, I ain't going up. Y'all going up with my blessing. He said, well, let all the king's son come up. Especially Amnon. Y'all with me on this? Amen. You have to know when somebody sing you out, they're getting ready to set you up.
That's right.
Come on, somebody. Amen. If they setting you up, you better be aware. Amen. Amen. David said, well, take all the king's sons up. It's amazing to me how some folks can get some information. I mean, they can come back and add a lie to it, twist it, mess it up. They say, you know, it ain't even what it was supposed to be. You know some people like that? Amen. Y'all won't say amen, just say mm-hmm. When all the king's sons, David's sons, went up to shear the sheep, which was an annual event, Amnon didn't know that Absalom, his half-brother, was going to murder him, was going to ambush him. Absalom told his servants, when he's full of wine,